When preparing for this video, I was trying to find a way to make cables exciting, but I couldn't come up with anything. So I'm not gonna lie, this will probably be one of the most boring videos that I've ever created. But you can't skip it. And here's why. You're never gonna get good sound unless you're using the right cables. So let's do this. This video is brought to you by Behringer X32 Mastery, the fastest way for church sound techs to master the X32. And with a team license, you can enroll unlimited team members now and in the future. Finally, everyone will be on the same page. Visit x32.church or click the link in the description to learn more. Well, hey, if we haven't met, I'm Cade, creator of Collaborate Worship, and we're dedicated to building confident worship teams. In other words, we want to help you master technical skills so your church can worship without distraction. So let's talk cables. I don't know why, but whoever created all this stuff decided to make things a little confusing for us. Like, why do cables for speakers look the same as cables for guitars? Yet if you get them mixed up, it causes all kinds of problems. So hang with me, because this video is gonna save you a lot of grief. Now there's three different kinds of cables, and each can go by a different name. And each of them can also have different types of connectors. Again, I don't know why all this has to be so difficult, but let me make it simple for you. And let's start with instrument cables, which are also called unbalanced cables. This is the cable that plugs into a guitar or a keyboard. And since it's an unbalanced cable, that means you'll never want it to be longer than 25 feet. Otherwise, you'll pick up hums, buzzes, and other unwanted noise. The problem is, your mixer is most likely more than 25 feet away from the guitar or keyboard. So you have to convert it to a balanced signal, which is where the direct box comes into play. Now, you've probably seen these little boxes up on the stage and wondered what the heck they were, and now you know. They convert an unbalanced signal to a balanced signal so that you can send it all the way to your mixer without picking up unwanted noise. Which leads us to the cable that comes out the other side of the direct box, a microphone cable, which is also called a balanced cable. This is the same exact cable that connects to a microphone, and since it carries a balanced signal, it can be run over 100 feet without picking up noise. All right, so there's two of the three cables. Now let's talk about number three, speaker cables. A speaker cable has a much heavier gauge or more wire because it has to carry some serious power. And although they can get confused with instrument cables because they look the same, you want to be careful this doesn't happen. You see, when using an instrument cable as a speaker cable, you're trying to send a large amount of power through these tiny little wires that were only designed to carry a tiny signal from a guitar or keyboard. It may work for a little while, but your speakers aren't going to sound very good and your amps are going to be working way harder than they need to. And in the worst case, you could melt the instrument cable and cause it to short circuit. All right, let's review. We have instrument cables, which are unbalanced, microphone cables, which are balanced, and speaker cables. So now let's talk about the different types of connectors. And the first one is called a TS connector, which has one ring on the tip. Now, this is the connector you will see on instrument cables and some speaker cables. To tell them apart, simply read the writing that's on the jacket of the cable. Next up is TRS connectors, which look just like the TS connector, only it has two rings on the tip instead of one. And these are used to carry a balanced signal. They're also used to carry a stereo signal, like on a pair of headphones, where you have a different signal for the left and the right headphone. Now this one's easy to point out, the XLR connector. It's one of the most common, and it's used to connect microphone and other balanced signals, like the output of a direct box. And lastly, there's two other connectors used on speaker cables. And I think this is the Audio Gnome's attempt at making things a little easier for us, instead of using the same connector as an instrument cable. Now, one of them is called a speak-on connector, and the other is a banana plug. Both of these are strictly used for speaker cables so that if you see them, you can be confident you're holding a speaker cable, not an instrument cable. I know it would be hard to remember all this right off the bat, so I've created a cable cheat sheet for you to download and print off. I'll include a link in the description. I've also provided a list of all the cables and direct boxes that I recommend using in the description. And if this doesn't make sense the first time, go ahead and replay this video, because at some point, you're gonna have to change out a cable, and you'll be thankful you know what to do. And hey, if you have questions, drop them in the comments, I'd be glad to answer. If you'd like to see more videos like this, give me a thumbs up to let me know. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the little bell so that we can let you know when a new video comes out. I'll see you next time.